up for the camera, guys.
Ready to begin an exciting week, inshallah ta'ala, with helping our Syrian refugees, spending time with the orphans, visiting our Palestinian refugees, helping the local needy population here, doing some sightseeing as well.
You are the hope for our clothes. Don't give up, no despair. There's nothing you can't repair. You can't change. Do not harm me, I am your truth. Don't kill me, for I'm your you. I am your hope, I am your truth. I'm your faith, yes, I'm your you.
Being here today, I got to experience a lot of fun times with the refugees. We played soccer, we played tug of war, played a couple of other games that I've never played in my life. But overall, just putting a smile on their face was probably one of the greatest things that I've experienced.
Messy like the angels in the rain. Messy like the sun, the moon, the stars. Messy like the angels in the rain. Messy like the sun, the moon, the stars. Blossoming flowers, bearing fruits, showing us the greatness of Allah. Blossoming flowers, bearing fruits, showing us the greatness of Allah.
We saw really don't have anything at all, but they're always able to offer, even though they don't have, whether it's just a smile or anything like that. I was really able to connect with the Syrians because I am Syrian. At this particular disability center, there was a girl who was thinking about Palestine. And it just really got to me. And
some might say, how could any father stand? See his children across many lands, suffer so, give no helping hand, no helping hand. Somewhere tonight, far away and out of sight. There's a child that's too weak to cry. Deep in those eyes, can't you see him in disguise? Reaching out to the heart that's in you. And every tear that is wet, he is there. Every tear that is wet, he is there. He's the hand that wipes the tears. He's the tear that trickles down on the face that cries without a sound. We need you now.
We need you now.
What is
we're bringing the items from one of the family's houses and we're putting them in helping hands build houses. And we're going to try to, inshallah, give all of these families one of the helping hands houses.
Somewhere inside, there's a part of you that asks why. What he needs so many souls for.
Before this trip, well, I heard about this trip through my sister because she came last year. And when she came back, all she ever talked about for that whole year was this trip. And when I told her that I was going to go and I really wanted to come to Jordan and work with everyone here, she told me that it was going to be the best experience of my life and that I was going to work with the greatest people.
Today was so hard to leave one of the girls. As I was reaching out for her hand from the bus, she was like, I'm going to cry because I'm leaving her. And we literally spent 5 minutes, and I'm just honored that I made such an impact in her life for those few moments. And you guys get to do this every single day. May Allah bless you all to be able to go back to those kids and visit them. And inshallah, I hope we can continue that as we go back to our own states and our own spaces and bring that joy to them, even if we're so far away. So thank you so much.
Assalamu alaikum. I just want to start off by saying thank you to Helping Hands for giving us all this opportunity to come here and, you know, experience something that, as Noor said, you know, we hear about on social media and on news all the time, but actually being here and witnessing and interacting with these children and these families, it's a whole nother world. It kind of makes it realistic in a sense, you know, seeing their living conditions and whatnot. But something that I really noticed is that despite, you know, the living conditions that these people are in, they're so incredibly kind. And like today in the tents, you know, they're literally living under cloth and they're handing us, sorry. Sorry. And you know, they're giving us tea, and from the little that they do have, and they're so grateful, and you know, their faith in Allah is so strong, and it's just something that I will never forget, and that I hope that I can take back and, you know, help them more.
Subhanallah, it's been completely eye-opening. It actually was not my first trip to the refugee camps. So I've visited the refugee camps before. I've visited refugees before. But this was something very different about this trip in particular.
Can't you see him in the sky, reaching out to the heart that's in you?